Mickey, you are no stranger to a big occasion because as well as being a snooker player, you're also an international footballer, is that correct?
Yeah, absolutely. Just been playing football for the last 14 years. After losing my leg as a child, I'm now playing disability football and disability snooker, so it's good to combine them both together.
And what does it mean to you to get to walk out as a snooker fan and play in the Crucible Theatre?
A boyhood dream, to be fair. Watching all your idols playing here, and now you're walking out, playing on the same venue, hopefully in front of a nice capacity. Hopefully I'll do a good job today, so looking forward to it.
And of course today is like a showcase for disability snooker, and we know the tour goes around the clubs and we're trying to get as many people involved as possible. What would be your message to anyone out there who loves the sport, who maybe has a disability? What would be your message to them this morning?
For those with disabilities who want to play snooker, definitely get involved, get down to your local club, speak to the right people, speak to the managers, just give it a go, because it doesn't matter what disability you've got, no matter whatever your disability, anyone can play this game. Get involved, because a lot of people who do get involved now obviously didn't know about it. I was one of those, I didn't know about it, I turned up to my local club and I'm walking out of the Crucible Theatre. What an absolute dream.
Good luck, Mark.
Thank you.
Daniel, a historic day for disability snooker. You're a few minutes away from walking out of the Crucible. How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling all right. You have to ask me again in a few minutes' time if I get a bit nervous, but at the moment, I'm just looking forward to it, excited to be honest with you. Very much so.
Did you ever think you'd get the chance to play snooker in the Crucible Theatre?
I certainly didn't expect it, no, but it was a nice surprise when I got the phone call, I'll tell you. Very nice. So I'm looking forward to it. So I'll give it my best shot and we'll see what happens.
Now, a lot of people don't realise that you players are just as competitive as the pros playing in the World Seniors here. You all want to win today as well as putting on a good show.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. But there's me and there's three other great players here. So I've got my work cut out. I've got to play well. So if I play well, I've got a chance. So let's just hope it's a good one.
We wish you all the best, Daniel.
Thank you very much indeed.
Good morning and a very warm welcome to WDBS Tour Championship here at the Crucible in Sheffield. This is semi-final number one. It's the best of three frames. It's time now to welcome the players. We begin with an England amputee football international, undefeated on the tour with three titles to his name. He's the reigning Northern Classic champion. From Preston, Mickey Chambers. And his opponent, a record 9-time tour event winner, the reigning Group 3 champion of champions, from Sutton Coldfield, Daniel Blum.
Thank you, gentlemen. If one of you would like to please call. It's heads.
Yes, good morning, everyone. Once again from the Crucible Theatre in Sheffield. An historic day here, as we've been hearing. This is the Disability Tour Championship featuring four of the best players from the World Disability Billiards and Snooker Tour.
First of two semi-finals. Best of three frames. The first frame, Mickey Chambers to break.
So we've got two semi-finals and the final. This is the first semi-final. Mickey Chambers breaking off against Daniel Blum. And the next match, as we saw the interviews earlier, Nick Neal and Shabir Ahmed. Daniel Blum, the most successful player in disability snooker. He's won a record 9 titles. Huge day for these guys, and good to see a nice crowd in supporting them. Michael Day is alongside me once again, as he was yesterday. Does a lot of work with the World Disability Billiards and Snooker Tour. And once again, Michael, that word crucible is the special one, isn't it? It's a big day for these guys. Yes, Dave. It's it's a real special occasion, a great opportunity for these four players to play at the home of snooker. We were saying yesterday, you know, this is our Wembley, so it's a fantastic opportunity for them this morning.
Mickey Chambers at the table has won all three events he's entered so far on the tour. Of course, there are different classes and categories. He also plays for the England amputee football team. Be interesting to see how he gets on here. Of course, he's got no teammates, unlike in football. It's all about how he does. And he's playing, as I say, very successful player in Daniel Blund from Sutton Coldfield. He has cerebral palsy. And he's played since the very first event that was staged on the tour in November 2015.
Yeah, Daniel turned up to the very first event we had back in 2015 at the Southwest Snooker Academy in Gloucester, and it's been a permanent fixture ever since. And he is the most decorated player on the circuit. He's got 9 titles, which is a remarkable achievement.
Mickey Chambers from Preston plays at the Elite Club, which is owned by a couple of former professionals, Chris Norbury and Shoka Ali. I tell you what, I was watching him on the practice table. He was knocking in the long balls for fun, but of course this is where the pressure comes on when you're out there in the arena. And just settling in as well to playing here at the Crucible. It's a nicely played shot. Judging the pace of the table, because it'll be a lot quicker than, I guess, the tables that they're used to playing on the tour.
Yeah, we go to sort of several different venues across the UK and in Europe as well. We've held events in Belgium over the last couple of years too. But some of those are very, very nice clubs, lovely conditions. But obviously here at the Crucible, in front of a crowd on television, it's going to be something very, very different for these two.
And I think a lot of people won't realise, Michael, that snooker was one of the original sports in the Paralympics, and indeed was in Paralympics until Seoul in 1988.
It's like you said, Dave, it was one of the founding sports of Paralympics back in 1960, and it was a permanent fixture every 4 years. And unfortunately, Seoul in Korea in 1988 was the last time it was on the program. And obviously before the Paralympics, it was part of the Stoke Mandeville Games as well. There was a snooker table at the establishment there, so snooker really does have a great heritage in terms of disability sport. And one of the aims of WDBS is obviously trying to get snooker back into the Paralympics, rightfully back in it, where it should be. And a lot of progress has been made in the last 4 years, and obviously that's exhibited this morning by playing at the Crucible Theatre.
Yes, it's a big step forward, this, for the disability game, and it again comes under the umbrella of snooker for all. It's one of the great things, I think, about snooker is that anyone can play. It's not like a sport where you have to go on a waiting list to join a club. You can just start playing. And this disability tour has really taken off the last couple of years. Now then, that was a mistake from Mickey Chambers. This is a chance, but just overcut the red. But I think Jason Francis, who did the interviews, made a good point. This is a showcase, but it's also a tournament, and they all want to win it.
Yes, yeah, all the players on the circuit are very competitive. I mean, the weekends we have, the weekend events we have throughout the season, they are great social gatherings as well, but all the players are competitive. They all want to win, and I know all four players this morning are determined to take home the trophy.
So Mickey Chambers in. He had his left foot amputated at the age of 4. 5 years later, he started playing snooker. As I say, though, he's also a footballer. Some great footage online of him playing amputee football.
Six.
Just wondering if he was trying to play a little cannon there, or if just the pace of the table just sort of outdid him there. But he's still on this red here. I think he can just sort of weave the cue ball in and out of balls and possibly get back on the blue. He's just overcut that.
I think we've already
seen
the added edge of pressure of being involved, not just here at the Crucible, but of course in a televised match. It's going to take maybe a while to settle down, understandably.
Seven.
Yeah, it's a nice opening rate there from Daniel Lee. Settle him down a little bit. Nicely on either brown or green.
Daniel Blunt started playing snook on a full-size table at the age of 10.
Four.
He's from Sutton Coldfield in the West Midlands.
Five.
Yeah, Dan sort of lives and breathes snooker, really, and obviously being a player himself, he's a big fan. I know he's a big fan of local player Dave Gilbert, lives near.
Well, if he's a fan of Dave Gilbert, he was put through a bit of a roller coaster at the World Championship. Of course, he reached the semi-finals and lost in a
10.
What was a heartbreaking decider to John Higgins. He had a kick, and that was a very emotional day actually, because of course the match had been 3 days long, and Dave got within touching distance of the final. Well, he's just lost his way here positionally. Yeah, so lost his way. That's end of break. Just while we watch this exchange, Michael, maybe you can tell us a bit more about the disability tour in terms of how many tournaments there are, and of course there are different categories, aren't there?
Yeah, that's right, Dave. The circuit over the last couple of years has really grown in terms of players and tournaments that we're holding. We're currently holding around sort of 9 or 10 tournaments a year. Players would generally play in their own groups. So what we mean by groups is players with a similar disability that they have. So we do have 8 disability classifications. But the 4 players we see today are sort of 4 of the best players overall on the WDBS circuit. So, just mopping his brow downs. But yeah, the circuit's really grown. As we say, we go to several clubs across the country, and recently we've moved into Belgium as well. Like I say, we have players on the circuit all over the UK who come to the events. We've even had players sort of representing India. We've had players over from Hong Kong, Poland, Belgium. And that's sort of the next phase for World Disability Billiards and snooker, is trying to get as many different nations on board.
Yellow ball.
And make people aware that this circuit is open to players with all disabilities. And, you know, look at the opportunities we're trying to create now, like playing in front of the crowd at the Crucible Theatre.
Yeah, this is sort of an all-star event, as Michael says, with 4 of the top players from the various categories.
And in terms of sort of the classifications, obviously we have players with sort of physical disabilities, groups 1 to 5, so that might be players playing from a wheelchair or other sort of ambulatory issues, players with amputation, things like that. We also have a learning disabilities group, which is group 6. We also have obviously deaf players and people with visual impairments as well. So, you know, we try to make this tour as inclusive as we can for players with disabilities, and you know, we would urge anybody who might be watching this with a disability to, you know, go online, have a look at our website, look at our Facebook page, on Twitter, We run open days at events as well, so try and get some information. You know, you will be welcome to our events if you fancy coming along and giving it a go.
He was unlucky there, wasn't he? Just finished behind the pink. Could have been on the black to the middle.
Daniel Blunt, one.
Talking earlier, Dave, that's Daniel's a big Dave Gilbert fan. I understand he's actually in the Crucible watching, so that's obviously going to add a little bit of pressure for Daniel, but I'm sure he'll really thrive on that.
That's good to know, isn't it? I wonder how Dave feels though, coming back here after that experience.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a big boost for Daniel. Yeah, like I say, he was a bit unlucky that last visit. Just finished awkward behind the pink, had to play safe.
Yep, that's a nice shot there from Mickey. Nice pace. A little bit close to comfort with Ian off, but he'll be happy with that.
Sarah McManus there in the background, the referee, big day for her as well. First time refereeing here at the Crucible.
Yes, Sarah's been with us from the start. She's been to so many events, and she's buzzing like the players are this morning to actually get out into the arena. So it's a big day for her. And Roy Gannon, we'll see Roy later on. They're both two very familiar and friendly figures on the circuit.
So a chance now for Mickey Chambers. Seven behind as he comes to the table. Yeah, he's won three tournaments and he's only entered three tournaments, so at the moment he's unbeaten on the Disabilities Tour. Like I say, he seemed very confident on the practice table, but obviously this is where it matters, out in the arena.
Seven. Eight.
Yeah, that was always going to be catching that red. So
Chambers, eight.
Be disappointed, I think, there. That was a chance to certainly put a few together.
Yeah, he will be disappointed. I'm just wondering whether or not the red near the pocket was some sort of bit of a nuisance to him in his eye line. But, yeah, he'll be upset that he didn't make more from that.
One.
Obviously, Dan was trying to get top side of the blue there, but he's just on the wrong angle, so I think you can sort of roll it through and sort of stay on one of these reds.
Just to reiterate, it's best of three, but if it were to go one each, the match would be resolved on a
six.
Black ball, a respot, as we saw yesterday in the first women's semi-final. Rhiann Evans actually trebled the respot against Mink from Thailand.
That was my shot there from Daniel, giving him a bit of confidence.
Yeah, this black is just slightly in the way, making this harder than it could have been. Knocks it in though.
13.
Need a stepladder, he says. Yeah, I think the thing there is again the pace of the table, where the cue ball's finished. It's finished so far over the right hand side. Just a faster table than he'd be used to playing on. So the long rest and the extension on the cue. Well, you've got another extension on. Is there any more extensions? He'll be playing this outside.
Yeah, I think call for the scaffolding in a minute.
There's a lot of length here on these, on the rest and on the cue. A delicate shot. Obviously, got to get a little closer to the cue ball. Slide the rest in a little bit more. Now get everything out of the way. That's the other thing. We've seen that in matches down the years where players have dropped something. But anyway, it's all been extricated. He seems to be enjoying it so far. He was saying beforehand he didn't feel too nervous, just to, obviously excited to be here.
Well, knowing Daniel, I know he'll be relishing this, as will the other three players. It's it must be a great feeling to play at the Crucible Theatre. And as we said, you know, WDBS was only sort of created 4 years ago. So 4 years ago, there wasn't anything like this. So the actual expansion of the circuit, now the opportunities that the players have, it's quite a remarkable turnaround within 4 years.
Brown ball.
He wasn't ideal on the brown. He got close to it.
14.
But it's in the break. He's got a 13-point lead with four reds remaining. Well, he's got a 13-point lead. There's three safe reds, but of course he's going to need them, so it's not necessarily an advantage, but at the moment trying to keep things tight. Thank you. joining us. This is the Disability Tour Championship live from the Crucible in Sheffield, showcasing four of the best players on the World Disability Billiards and Snooker Tour. Daniel Blunn and Mickey Chambers in the first match. Our next match will be Nick Neal against Shabir Ahmed. Let's open things up now. Big day, of course, with the World Seniors Championship semi-finals and final to come later on. Well, he may take this red on. No, just a safety. As I say, he was knocking all sorts in the practice table, but this is a match now, and he doesn't want to hand the frame to Daniel Blunt. Sure we'll be taking this one on. A chance now, and these reds, as I say, they were safe a minute ago, but they're in play now, so it could be about one good pot here from Mickey Chambers.
Yeah, that was a top red that he was potting in practice, although he's just lost the cue ball slightly there.
Yeah, that's why you just saw a little bit of disappointment from him, even though it was a good pot. Didn't get position.
Pink ball.
Well, not ideal position anyway, but he's not the pinking.
Seven.
This is a terrific pot, actually. Although it was played with a degree of safety in mind. So 6 points in this opening frame.
Mickey Chambers, seven.
Nice containing safety there from Daniel.
Yeah, he holds his hand up. The double kiss, actually not the worst outcome there. Doesn't matter what former snooker it is and who's playing, a bit of luck here and there can make a difference. Double kiss.
Thank you.
So a chance for Chambers, he's six behind.
Yeah, that looked awkward, didn't it? Obviously, he went for the pot, but I don't think he's too upset with the outcome there. Make him feel a lot better.
Well, what a pot that was. It's like Judd Trump. Let's look at this again. A very acute angle going into that pocket, actually. Terrific. Another good shot there. Problem though, and we see this, if you have a scrappy frame, the colours go awkward, so the yellow's awkward. It's actually probably the only colour that is. Still this slash red to deal with though, not in an ideal position.
It's a little bit of a rerun, like yesterday's women's matches, wasn't it? The opening couple of frames went very close, sort of decided on the last red. We've got a close finish here as well. Although we won't be too happy with that one, that was a bit of a flyer.
Mickey Chambers, 10.
Still the issue of the yellow, though, even though he's left a chance at the red. But he has got himself 4 points in front.
One. Daniel Blunt, 1.
So, as I say, this yellow's been really the only safe colour, and we're now on the yellow, and it's a tight finish to this opening frame. Just 3 points in it. It's not his best shot. He has left a chance at the yellow to the middle, and if he can pot it and get on the green, it's a definite chance to win the opening frame. Not quite fluke the snooker, I don't think. And we know Mickey Chambers likes to take on long balls. Not taking this one on, though. I think just a sign of where we are in the frame there. Feeling he'll be taking this one on.
Nice safety there from Daniel. Mentioned earlier how sort of snooker crazy Daniel is. He's actually also a qualified referee. He's actually refereed events on the WDBS circuit. He's also a community coach as well. So snooker plays a very big part of his life.
Yeah, and that's why playing at the Crucible means so much to him, because he'll have watched all the World Championships and what an opportunity just to experience this unique atmosphere. As well for all the families here supporting the various players. Is there a gap? Applause, but the reaction from Mickey Chambers suggests he can get through to the yellow. It's pretty tight. Yeah, you can see he can actually snick this in. It was a good effort actually from Chambers to snooker him, but he can just cut this in. Well, this is a chance now. He's played that well.
Daniel Blum, two.
Yeah, I think that was because he was trying to sort of bang out an angle there. I think that's why he took his sort of eye off the green. Thankfully for him, though, it has run safe. But Daniel will be disappointed there that he only made two.
Foul. Daniel Blum, four.
Although he'll be slightly happier seeing that cue ball go in.
Yeah, he's just working out what difference that makes to the scores, and what it means actually is that green, brown and blue, and it would be snookers required. He'd be 15 in front with 13 on. Terrific pot, but this white's going to keep on running. Well, he may be on it to the middle. He's terrific green, actually. Mickey Chambers may be feeling that in off has been an important moment in this frame. You can see from that camera angle that you've got to be so exact if you're going to try and drop it in the middle. He has done, and as I say, with the in off, it means he just needs the blue, and he'll be 15 up with 13 on. So he doesn't have to worry about playing for the pink. Put everything into the pot. This blue's still got a chance. Oh, wow. That's incredible. Frame ball. What a sitner for Mickey Chambers. It started with that in off, but it was a great green. It was a nice brown as well. He's fluked the blue. Wow. Just try and drop the pink in or over the pocket, because then Chambers has got to keep it out. He's going to get the snooker. So the pink is over the pocket. He hasn't got the snooker. Yeah, that in off was a key moment in the frame. It was nip and tuck until then. In goes the pink. So Daniel Blund takes the opening frame of this semi-final here in the Disabilities Tour Championship at the Crucible. Remember, it's best of three to reach the final. Daniel Blund leading Mickey Chambers here in Sheffield by 1-0.
Frame number two, Daniel Blund to break.
Welcome back to the Crucible here in Sheffield. Theatre of dreams for all snooker players. This is the Disabilities Tour Championship, the first semi-final. Daniel Blund against Mickey Chambers, and Daniel Blund won a very tight opening frame. Let's be honest, he was a little fortunate to fluke the blue, which was frame ball. But he potted a terrific green and a good brown prior to that. It's best of three, so he needs one more. If Mickey Chambers does level up, then the decider will be a respotted black, and then we'll have the next semi-final, Nick Neal against Shabir Ahmed. Going close. But I was going to say, he likes that pocket. That's where the blue went in, but the red has stayed out. A little smile from Mickey there. I think I recognise that would have been another bit of big luck for Daniel. This time it stayed out though, so it's a chance for Chambers. Reminder that Daniel Blund is the most successful player on the World Disability Billiards and Snooker Tour. 9 titles he's won so far, having played in the very first event 4 years ago. He's also an Aston Villa fan, but I guess you can't have everything.
Well, he's been happy over the last few months anyway.
Yeah, of course, his opponent is a footballer. Mickey Chambers plays for the England amputee team.
Yeah, if people out there get a chance to actually see Mickey online, there's some great footage on YouTube of him playing for England, scoring goals. And I remember the first time I met Mickey at an event in Preston. He was telling me where I think it was Mexico, he went to one of the football tournaments and playing in front of a capacity crowd over there. He said that was a really sort of daunting experience, so this is another one he can add to his list this morning. And you see, he's got a chance here, potentially. Let's just have a look to see if the black's available, though.
Yeah, it's a different sort of environment, isn't it? As I said earlier, you're on your own. It's silent, it's quite forbidding, unlike in a football stadium where everyone's making a lot of noise. Wow. But he has got a chance here to get going in frame two.
Eight. 9.
Again, you just see how quick the table was there, but it's just held up in time.
Bramble.
This will be a little bit tester with the rest, though. Nicely played, nicely controlled as well. He's good on this black here. Got a nice angle to come out for another red.
It was a lovely shot, actually, wasn't it, with the rest? Nicely controlled. Oh, but then he misses that one, and he'd be so annoyed. Just starting to produce something there, particularly that last shot with the rest, and then maybe just slightly took the black for granted. That can happen. Yeah, to the near jaw, and you can see he was really annoyed by that. As we said at the start, this is a showcase for disability game, but it's also a tournament. And these guys are all looking to win a title at the Crucible. I mean, what a great thing to have on your CV. Let's talk about the World Professional Championship here. John Spencer was the first winner of the championship in 1977. He could always say he was the first to do it. Meanwhile, Daniel Blund just losing the cue ball there.
One.
Michael, if there are people watching who maybe they didn't know about the disability tour but are interested in taking part, how do they do that?
Well, there's a few ways, Dave. In fact, we've got a next event is the UK Disability Championships in September at Barrett Snooker Club in Northampton. But there's a lot online. We obviously have a website, World Disability Billiards and Snooker. If you go online, there's lots of information about what we've already done, what we plan to do. We're also on Facebook. We're also on Twitter. There is a little bit of sort of video footage online as well under the WBBSA banner as well. So, like I say, if you've got any questions as well about the circuit, if you want to know what you need to do in order to sort of qualify for the circuit and criteria and everything like that, please get in touch with us, and we're more than happy to answer your questions.
Yeah, and who's to say that in due course, you know, you could end up here at the Crucible playing in one of these events. That was another half chance for Mickey Chambers, who had a better chance, of course, on his last visit, missed that black. He's looking to level up and force a decider, which would be a respotted black. Be careful of that waistcoat of the red. Yeah, it's just red first, and he's on the blue to the middle.
Might have seen there that was awkward queuing as it was, but obviously for some of our disability players it's even more awkward queuing, but what amazes me and other people who might watch the circuit when we play at certain clubs and events is how players with these disabilities sort of get around that to play a sport that they love. And we even have sort of players with limbs Bramble. Missing and it makes special adaptments to actually play the sport that that they love and competitively as well. And you know, it really is sort of fantastic to see.
Yeah, I think snooker's always prided itself on being a sport for everybody. As I said earlier, it's not an elitist sport in any way. Anyone can join a club. Not everyone's going to be world champion, obviously, but just the opportunity to play and pursue something that you enjoy is great. And to have rewards like this coming here is terrific. Meanwhile, though, Daniel Blunn has left a chance here for Chambers. Table's gone a bit awkward. The black's tied up. Well, it's in play now, or it's less safe, but he's missed the red.
Daniel Blum, 3.
Yeah, I think Mickey Chambers is just trying to make something happen in this match. Potted a few good balls in the first frame, but ultimately, of course, didn't win it. And just trying to get himself going. He did have a good chance, it's got to be said, early in this frame. Missed that black off the spot. I think, obviously, he knows he can play a lot better than he's shown so far today, but the environment and the additional pressure maybe has made a difference. It also, it's been a little bit scrappy, so balls have gone awkward. But we've seen this so many times at the Crucible. You see players who qualify for the World Professional Championship really excited, and I'm just going to go out there and enjoy it. And of course, when they get here, it's not long till the head shaking starts, because it can be so frustrating snooker when suddenly that form that you've shown to get here hasn't quite turned up with you. That added edge of pressure has made all the difference. It was a bit wild, but the question is, has he left a chance at the same red to the green pocket? Doesn't look like it. So 3 points in this second frame.
just being a containing safety there, I think the red being in the bulk was a bit of a problem for Daniel to play the cue ball up there. That's a lovely double though from Nicky. Played it with an element of safety, bit of a shot to nothing. He is on this pink, but again, this will be a little tester for him. Shot. I think he's trying to hold the pink spot here, and I think that's the reason why he's looking a little bit frustrated. He's hoping that this pink doesn't respot, because if it does, he's going to be hampered. And unfortunately for him, that's bad news. This has got very awkward all of a sudden. Yeah, that's a nice shot there. He'd be happy with that. And I think he's got an angle here on the black. Obviously, we're going into the reds, it'd be developing them. So this is another big shot here for Mickey. Shot, wasn't it? That's beautiful, and that's opened everything up, and this is a real chance now for Mickey to establish a fantastic lead here.
15.
It really is, but he's got to now focus, because of course he was in earlier in the frame and I think just slightly took his eye off the black that he missed to the left corner. He knows this is a good chance.
16.
Don't think he lacks for guts, does he? He seems a very confident character. Sort of chance you're looking for in a frame, this. Looking to take us to a respot finish.
23. 24.
Well, we started with that good double. To put him 33 points in front.
Thirty-one.
30. He has really sort of created this chance by himself for that double, and he has played a couple of tricky shots in this break so far, but he's sort of edging towards the snooker's required stage here.
Yeah, that shot as well when he was hampered over the pink was terrific. But
35.
It's just gone wrong, and he's not over the line yet. 38 the lead, 43 on. So he's just looking for another red.
Yellow ball.
I guess he's looking to leave yellow and brown sort of tied up, because Daniel Blunt's going to need them. He could try and get him in behind the yellow.
Yellow ball.
Just a delicate shot to snooker him. Or behind the brown, for that matter.
Mickey Chambers, 35.
35, highest break so far from Mickey Chambers. But, was, as I say, was just looking for another red there. Overcut the red, and it's bad news for Daniel Blunt, because Mickey Chambers, he knows, needs just one more red, and it's snookers required. So it looks like we're heading for a respot finish. Like this green in, it would then be two snookers needed. At the moment it's one to tie. And he's on this red as well. Put together a good break. It wasn't a frame winning break, that 35, but it got him on the brink.
Four.
Well, the red's not in, so there's still a glimmer here for
Mickey Chambers.
Daniel
Four.
Blunt. 42 behind 35 on. Chambers has fluked a snooker, and that hit in the black. Foul. Surely his end of frame.
Mickey Chambers.
Now 49
seven.
Behind with 35 on. So in fact needs four snookers. And in goes the red. So it's going to be a respot to decide who is first into the final. Mickey Chambers kept on trying to make things happen, and in this frame they did happen for him. So Daniel Blunt concedes. It's 1-1, and it means that, as I say, the semi-final will be decided on a respotted black. So great drama to start the day here in Sheffield. Yeah, I felt, as I say, Chambers kept on trying to get in, and in the end he did. He put together a good 35. And he's got the frame on the scoreboard. Sarah McManus
Gentlemen.
Puts the black on its spot. They're going to toss a coin.
It is tails.
Daniel Blunt has won. He's put Mickey Chambers into bat. So this black ball will decide our first finalist.
An interesting way he's played that black there. I'm not obviously he's a left angle opportunity. Big shot coming up.
Daniel Blunn, the most decorated player in disability snooker, has won 9 titles. He needs this black to put himself in the Tour Championship final here at the Crucible. Now it's all about where it finishes. You'd like it on the cushion. It's one of these. It's a thin one, and if he were to take it on, miss it, he could leave it basically in the jaws of the pocket. Presumably why he turned it down. Good shot he's played.
Yeah, that was a nice one there. You could see he was sort of sizing up the possibility of going for the pot, but I think that was the prudent option there. Lovely response though from Daniel, it's a beautiful shot.
Again, this is tough, but it is a chance.
Great pot. Terrific pot from Daniel Blunn. He knocks in the re-spot to win our first semi-final. That was a terrific black. And there's the clenched fist that tells you who is our first man into the final. So a thrilling finish. And it's Daniel Blunn, the most successful player in disability snooker, into the final. He will play either Nick Neal or Shabir Ahmed. That will be our second semi-final coming up shortly.